Look at me, I got a modern Chinese fan. My goodness. It's probably a piece of crap. Oh well, this one is from Sears. I like the colors. Got it on sale. Can't go wrong. Pretty cheap. Curious to see how this one will work. It is Kenmore branded, but probably not Kenmore made. I'm gonna bet $100. And no one will take me up on that bet because I give up now. 12-inch table fan, oscillating, and adjustable tilt. What amazing features that have never been seen before. Adjustable tilt head, decent airflow where you want it. Easy push settings. I don't think that's what it actually looks like on the front, but we'll see. For household use only, 1-year warranty. Well, maybe it has a 1-year warranty. See what lurks inside. We have a manual. Kenmore 12-inch table fan. I'll let you take a look at this. Yes, I'm sure I know how to assemble it. And that's it. Fuse replacement. Oh, goody, it has a fuse plug. And that's all that's in the box. It's actually packed pretty nicely. They have this styrofoam stuff on it. It's real skinny there. Real skinny little part of it that goes in that big base. It's kind of fun. That looks like it's actually kind of small. Usually they're longer than that. It's probably just a real basic shape, but no, it actually does have a... It actually has kind of a decent-sized motor in there. Alright, let's get it out of the bag. Which is, of course, taped shut. I don't like that because I can't rebox it the same way it came out. Because I gotta rip the bag. Is there any way to get this tape off nicely? Oh, maybe there is. Oh, there was. Fantastic. Oh, that's a nice smooth plastic, actually. And there's not a mark on it. Usually there's like dings and stuff on here from shipping damage. There's nothing. That is shiny. These don't feel the greatest, but it feels like they'll work. I probably got fingerprints all over this now. That actually does feel pretty good. Yeah, the motor is a relatively decent size. The oscillator is actually really small. Can you see it? Lots of air vents too. Maybe this thing might be not as bad as the rest. I like how they protected the shaft with the foam. Now, before we go any further, I am going to put some lubricant in here. Because remember that freak show with the Impress fan didn't even have any oil in it? None whatsoever? So we're going to do that right now before I even run it. And the motor gets all screwed up because it's trying to spin with no lubricant. Oh. We have an irremovable... Good grief, get on the film. We have an irremovable oscillator knob. That's not a screw. But this might be fun. It seriously looks like it can almost just be pulled off. Let me just try. Nope, not really. Okay, that's nice. So it looks like we might only be able to oil the front. I don't like that. Oh well, we'll oil the front. Okay, there's that. Let's open the base. Warning, keep this plastic bag well out of reach of children. That is a dangerous plastic bag. There's one screw, I guess, that holds it on. Oop, I adjusted the tilt. I think they're back. Oh. Here's the nut thing. And the tape is breaking. I guess it's been on there kind of longer than I thought. Get all the tape out. Okay, good. At least I don't have to clean the residue. In. And I just have to clip in the front first and then put these two down. There we go. That actually looks pretty nice. I like that. Let's put the screw in. I'm surprised this isn't a tool-less build. You do need tools to do it. Seems like it actually is holding pretty well with the tabs. Not too sure it even needs a screw, but there it is. Alright, what else do we have? We have information. Kenmore. Electric fan. Let's see, model. Thermally protected. It's a model 405.35012510. Are you kidding me? That is ridiculous. There's a couple marks on this here, but I think they'll come off. There's the blade. Get to that in a second. And there's the back guard. I'm not sure if this actually has one way or another the way it goes. Maybe like this? No, alright, that's right. Oh, you can't even see. Derp. It's relatively high. I'm going to compare this to a black comfort zone that I bought a couple of years ago, 12-inch, and I think this is up much higher than that off the table. Okay. There's the front guard. Let's put the blade in first. Now on the package, it's kind of interesting, on the package it claims that this is entirely clear. It's actually like a smoke gray type thing, which I like. So this matches the video I saw. Okay. Line that up. Get these little things off. And this is interesting. The clips to hold the guard on are on the back grill. There are none at all on the front. So we align it with the back guard and then use the tabs from the back guard to hold it on. That's kind of interesting. I've never seen that before. Kind of hard to get it in place though. There it is. We'll take this off. Nice shiny Kenmore. Shiny, shiny. And let's give it a test. We have fuse plug. It's replaceable. It's actually replaceable. We'll take that thing off. Are we ready to get the camera not far back enough? Actually, I gotta undo the twist tie here. Maybe that'll help. bring it back a little bit further. Let's get it off of oscillation. Leave it down a little bit more. And here we go. Oh! I forgot the nut thing that holds the blade on. Oh my gosh, this is a freak show to get the front guard back off. There we go. Yep, I didn't put the blade nut on there. That's incredible. It's actually a gap. It doesn't even go all the way back against the blade. Alright, let's try that again. A little bit further away from the camera. That sounds very unlubricated. Of course, there's not much I can do about it. Well, provided that's actually spinning at the proper speed, that's actually a really nice, quiet low. It's moving some air. I can feel it back a little ways. Moving a nice amount of air to sleep too. If only it weren't for those scraping noises. yeah, it definitely has to be lubricated a little bit. Medium. The blades have a really nice sound to them. That's a really nice, relaxing sound. And actually, the scraping sound's starting to go away. I guess the lubrication is kicking in. That is moving considerable more air, too. And all the way up. And a teeny bit of guard rattling. It seems I just fixed that. That's really quiet. And it's moving, actually, quite a bit of air. Oops. That's moving a really nice amount of air. That moves more than the comfort zone did, that's for sure. I can feel that a good 12 feet back. It's forceful, but not too forceful. Yeah, I really like the low speed. That's actually really quiet. That's a nice low. I don't think there's any startup noises. No, there's no startup sound. Not too bad, actually. Okay, that has been the Kenmore thing, and actually the camera wasn't quite zoomed out all the way. Thank you for watching.